To you in the blessed name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today there are two very, very important days which we are observing. The first one is the whole world is in awe of having the solar eclipse today. And there are so many superstitions which come through the solar eclipse. But we should not be worried about it. It is just a natural phenomena which is happening. The another one, which is very great for all of us, and that is the celebration of Father's Day. As we speak, as we hear this wonderful word, known as Father, I think there is a smile on our face. We remember our Father who has given us so much. It is a time today that we honor all our fathers. So my congratulations to all the fathers. You have indeed worked so hard to bring the family, to look after the children and make them to stand and walk on their feet. Shall we give a big round of applause to all our fathers and congratulations. Thank you. May God bless you on this very special day. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. It was the lady, her name was Sonora Smart. And on the Mother's Day in the month of May, when the church were observing the Mother's Day, Sonora, sitting in the church pew, she was thinking about her father. Her father, he was an army man who had fought in many battles. She did not have mother. She was among the six siblings. And that day, she was remembering the contribution of her father in her life. How he worked so hard to bring all the siblings together. She gave importance to celebrate, along with Mother's Day, also the Father's Day. She wanted to have this Father's Day on 5th of June. But gradually, it was President Vincent Collins who declared as the 19th June as the holiday for Father's Day. My dear friends, since then, we honor our father. The world celebrates this Father's Day on the third week of June. So thus, today, as we celebrate the Father's Day, though in the church, fathers are not there, but my prayer and my gratefulness and my prayer for every father. My dear friends, in 10 commandments, Exodus chapter 20, verse 12, it says, honor your father and mother, and your days may be long in the land which Lord your God has given to you. Unfortunately, we are living in a world which is very fast, which is growing very, very fast. And thus, our duties, our responsibilities, our priorities also being changed. The family life, the family values, the family bond, it is gradually losing. And in such a way that we are not being able to give due respect and honor to our elderly people. One of the concern which we have is a growing number of old age homes that we look after our old age people. We continue to serve them through the old age homes. But at the same time, my concern is that parents are not living with their children. Children are so busy in their career, in their works, and then we are neglecting our parents. My dear friends, someone gave this piece of paper If you ask any girl, who is your hero? And she will definitely say, my daddy is my first hero. If you ask any child, he will say, my daddy is strongest. My father is very, very strong. And that's so wonderful, that grows. A four-year-old child says, my papa, he can do anything. Seven-year-old child says, my papa, he knows a lot, whole lot of things he knows. Gradually, 8-year-old child says, well, my papa does not quite know everything. 12-year-old child says, oh, well, naturally, my father does not know everything. 14-year-old child says, father is hopelessly, he's old-fashioned man. Then we see, 21-year-old says, oh, that man is out of date. What will you expect from him? 25-year-old, he says, my father, he knows a little bit about it, but he does not know much about that. 30-year-old says, I must find out what my daddy, he thinks about it. 35-year-old says, let me get my father's meaning first. 50-year-old say, what would dad have thought about it? See, as the life progresses, we understand that how important the value of father. 60-year-old says, my daddy, he knew literally everything. He knew everything. Then we see the 65-year-old man says, I wish I could talk it over with my father. So see, friends, we see the father figure in our life. We understand, as we grow old, we understand what our fathers, they have gone through in their life. And at the last, you will say, my father, he is really my hero in my life. The contribution which they make. But friends, we are a society searching for a model father. As we say, that the children, they grow in the image of the father. The father says, son, be careful. Be careful. Be careful where you step, where you go about. And the son replied, you be careful because I am following your steps, role model for all of us. And this is why we, the fathers, we have a special duty and responsibility towards nurturing our children, towards our society, the values, the moral we give to our children forever. I would like to share something with you. A godly father's love God. Unto you is teaching us the first authority which we need to get is God and searching his kingdom value. I remember in my age time when I used to get up, I saw my father with his Bible. I saw my father having a cup of tea in his hand and he will be sipping, but not a single day I saw him out his Bible early in the morning. As I brush, as I fresh up and I come and sit with my father, he will offer me a cup of tea and we will discuss about the biblical message gathered with us. My dear friends, today my father, he is in advanced age. He is in around 86 years of age, and then gradually in the process he is slightly not being able to pronounce correct words. It slips from his mind. But till now, by God's grace, he never took a single medicine for any ailment. He is absolutely fine and fit. But now, with the age, he is not being able to remember many things. And thus, he is not being able to construct his sentences. A few days back, when I continue to read your Bible, because it will give you the mental strength. And every morning, he makes sure that he reads his Bible. He prays to God. I look at him with great honor and respect. The values which he gave me from my childhood, teaching me to read the Bible, to read the passage of God. A godly father loves God. Second quality which I would like to share, godly father loves his wife. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 25 to 31, 33. I would like to read this beautiful passage with you. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 25 onwards. Husband, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her in order to make her holy by cleansing her with the washing of water by the word, so as to present the church to himself in splendor, without a spot or wrinkle or anything of the kind. Yes, so that she may be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as they do their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hates his own body, but the nourishes and tenderly cares for it, just as Christ does for the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I am applying to it Christ the church. Each of you, however, should love his wife as himself, and a wife should respect her husband. My friends, a beautiful passage which Bible has teaches us as a true husband, as a true daddy. The Bible teaches us to love and respect your life partner. Bible says that the husband and wife will leave their parents, but they will be one body and one soul. They will walk together. The quality which we are losing is between the love and respect between husband and wife. There is hardly the respect and love shown, and thus the families are being broken. This impacts the child also, and then it becomes difficult for children to grow. My friends, the Bible teaches all father to love his wife. When the father loves the wife, the mother of his children, the children, they get great values, great respect towards the whole society, and a very strong bond with the family. My dear fathers, love your wife. Your son will respect all the women of the world. They will have a great respect and honor to all the women. Today, one of the deteriorating morality which we see is towards the attitude towards female. Where from it comes? It comes right from the family. And if a father does not respect the mother and has a different attitude, that will surely impact the life on the children. As we see today, the growing crimes which is happening against women, it is a matter of serious concern. If the father loves his wife and teaches to honor everybody, I think the society will be a different society, where the bond of father and his children and society will be strong. My dear friends, it is our duty, our responsibility. What God has given us, we should respect and we should honor. The third characteristics which I would like to share with you: godly father love his children. And I'm so happy today, as we read about prodigal son's story. We have seen Jesus shared this parable with all of us, showing how God is so loving. So lovely. I think one of the beautiful story, which I really enjoy even reading now again and again, is a story of prodigal son. That shows the whole character of father. In spite of all bitterness, he loves his children. Though he was a prodigal, but yet he loved him so dearly. Today, the parents are not being able to spend time with their children. Children are left alone to think, to decide. And even children are not being able to take the correct decision. When we do not give our time to our children, we are not doing justice. God has given us a responsibility towards our children. We must spend a quality time with them. Even going out, praying together. And these are some great values. The children, as they grow in their life, they will continue to remember these beautiful virtues which the family gives us. All the parents must spend time with children. Now, in this fast technology, where the mobile has become more and more important and necessary, I think we are further losing our time with our children. The TV shows, the movies, which we used to enjoy together, I think we are now separated. Let these devices, they speak to us, but we have hardly any time to speak to our children. Please spend your time with your children. It's a quality time which you are giving to them. When you speak to them, you share your experience with your children. Yes, it is important that sometime you scold them when the children, they do not follow you or they do not do good. Sometime it is good that we scold them, but it is always good that this scolding should also be in love and in respect. So the children, they understand it first. Colossians chapter 3, verse 21 says, "Do not beat your children." I was so happy to hear Father Gaikwad, he was sharing a beautiful story. As the father was teaching to the son, as he gets angry, to nail his anger on the door. It is also so important that this story is not only for that son. It is a story for us also, for elders. We lose our temper very fast. And particularly when we get angry, we scold, or sometimes we raise our hands on our children. that becomes a difficult and a painful experience. And it may happen, the children, they may grow with that bitterness. Bible says, do not beat your children. Rather, spend your quality time with children so that they would be able to understand what my parents, they are expecting from me. Encourage them in every way. Whatever possible ways and means, it will be so wonderful. I remember this beautiful story. Father is so busy in his work, hardly spends any time with the child, with this little daughter. One day, in the late night, when daddy comes, this little daughter, she is peeping through the door. She's trying to get the attention from her father. And her father, who was so tired, as he saw his daughter, he just shouted at her, "What happened? Why are you there? Go, go to your room, go sleep." But this little girl, she continued to be there, staring at her father. The father, he comes to her, put his hands on the girl's head and lifted him. And he said, "Tell me, what's wrong with you?" This child says, "Daddy, can I get 1 minute from you?" Then he said, "Surely, my daughter, surely. Yes, tell me." She takes the finger of her father and lead him towards her room. There she sat down and she took out her guinea box where she used to keep some money. Then she said to her father, "Father, how much do you earn every hour?" Father said, "Perhaps I earn 100 rupees per hour." Then this girl, she opened the box and she gathered all her coins together. Perhaps it was not 100 rupees. But whatever she had, she offered to her daddy and said, "Only this much I have. Can you spend some time with me?" My friends, the father was broken. He could understand what the child is looking. Spend the time with the children. It is wonderful to have our children talking to us. One more thing, the quality is not only for father, it is for parents. A godly father is a man of integrity. Honesty is the best policy. Let us teach to be truthful all the time. One of the important issues, which particularly our country is facing, is the whole issue of integrity, the truthfulness, the corruption which we have in society. Where does it come from? Do we learn this from outside, or it is originates right from our family? I think this issue can be dealt with if we have a great virtues of being integrated into the love of God. My friends, it is important that we follow our parents, those who are so honest. Let us not compromise anything when it comes to the issue of honesty. Let us teach our children how to be honest. Let us teach them how they can face life, how they can struggle in life and come out with all successful without being corrupt, without being disobedient, without being untruthful. This is great values which we need to inculcate in our children. It is important. My dear friends, teach them not to be corrupt. A phone call comes and the child goes and he picks up the phone. "Hello?" Yes. The other side says, I want to speak to your daddy. Who is this speaking? No, I am so and so. And the child, he says, please hold on. He goes to the father and says, so and so is on the line. Father says, I don't want to speak to this man. Go and tell him, father is not at home. Simple thing. Father is not at home. And this child goes back. He took the receiver and says, my father is saying that I am not at home. Just imagine, father is teaching, telling, it's okay to avoid certain things. You can speak lies. It is so difficult. My friends, if this small, small things do not matter, how can we be a role model for a child? Fathers, do not lose your integrity and honesty at any cost. When you will be truthful, the child will learn to be truthful ever and ever. And I think that is the great virtues. Being as a Christian father, we need to be honest and we need to continue to teach them. A godly father is a role model of God. How do we see our God? We see him so loving. We see him so kind. He does not count all of our sins. He does not count how many mistakes we have done. He keeps forgiving. He keeps loving. And the beautiful story of this prodigal sons remind us, father would have been so bitter when the son, he decided, give me my share. I want to go and leave my life. But when he had spent everything, he comes back to his father. And the Bible says, the father, every day, he is longing to see his son who has gone away. When the son returns, he does not count, you did this, you did that, I was so angry with you. It doesn't count all those things. He just ordered to all his servants, go and bring the best. Our father is the one who gives us the best. We may have committed so many sins. We may have committed so many mistakes in our life. It's a part of our nature. But when we bring all these into the God's feet, God does not count any of our mistakes. He embraces us. He forgives us. He gives us a perfect honor and respect to every one of us. God is our role model. Father on earth needs to be like Heavenly Father, forgiving, loving, and so generous. My dear friends, I recognize and I realize the importance which father gives to the family. Perhaps sometime what we do, the children are so close to mother, sometimes father shows them that he is very, very strict. But in heart, he is so fragile. He is so loving. Do you remember the time which you spent with your father? Is so fine, so wonderful, is so wonderful. I would like to dedicate this poem to all the fathers, teaching and learning that how our role of father, which has happened to us. This is in Hindi, and I would like to share with you. Kabhi abhiman, to kabhi swabhiman hai pita. Kabhi dharti, to kabhi asman hai pita. जन्म दिया है अगर माँ ने, जन्म दिया है अगर माँ ने, जानेगा जिससे संसार वो पहचान है पिता। कभी कंधे पर बिठाकर मेला दिखाता है पिता, कभी बन के घोड़ा बच्चों को घुमाता है पिता। माँ अगर पैरों से चलना सिखाती है, माँ अगर पैरों में चलना सिखाती है, तो पैरों पर खड़ा होकर चलना सिखाता है पिता। कभी रोटी तो कभी पानी है पिता, कभी बुढ़ापा तो कभी जवानी है पिता। माँ अगर है मासूम सी लोरी, माँ अगर है एक मासूम सी लोरी, तो कभी ना भूल पाऊंगा वो कहानी है पिता। कभी हंसी तो कभी अनुशासन है पिता, कभी मौन तो कभी भाषण है पिता। When the father scolds, the children से भाषण दे रहा है पापा भाषण दे रहा है। Beautiful verse says, कभी हंसी तो कभी अनुशासन है पिता, कभी मौन तो कभी भाषण है पिता। माँ अगर घर में रसोई है, रसोई मतलब किचन, माँ अगर घर में रसोई है तो चलता है घर जिससे वो राशन है पिता। कभी ख्वाब को पूरी करूं, कभी ख्वाब को पूरा करने की जिम्मेदारी है पिता। कभी आंसुओं में छिपी एक लाचारी है पिता। बागर बेच सकती है जरूरत में अपने सारे गहने, गहने ऑल द ज्वेलरी। व्हेन द फैमिली, व्हेन दे डू नॉट हैव एनीथिंग एंड देन सम स्ट्रगल कम्स, इट इज मदर हु ब्रिंग्स ऑल हर बैंगल्स, ऑल हर इयररिंग्स एंड आस्क फादर प्लीज सेल इट फॉर द फैमिली। ज्वेलरी, द गहने। माँ अगर बेच सकती है जरूरत में गहने, तो जो अपने को ही बेच दे वो व्यापारी है पिता। कभी हंसी और कभी खुशी का मेला है पिता। कभी कितना तन्हा और अकेला है पिता। माँ तो कह देती है अपने दिल की बात, माँ तो कह देती है अपने दिल की बात। सब कुछ समेट के आसमान सा फैला है पिता। ऑन दिस फादर्स डे लेट अवर गॉड कंटिन्यू टू लव ऑल अवर डियर फादर। हैप्पी फादर्स डे, मे गॉड ब्लेस यू।
In the light of the word God that we have received from our dear bishop, let us affirm our faith by saying the Nicene Creed. Shall we all stand? Section 14. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Once again, I on this very special day, Father's Day, our bishop has already conveyed a very good message to all of us. As far as the announcements are concerned, birthdays this week. Today is a special day, 21st June. It is the birthday of our deacon, Somin Daimari. It's also the birthday of Nula Luk Sangma, the grandson of Snigdha Sangma. 22nd June, we again have two birthdays. The first is that of Deepika Lingaya, who will be completing 70 years. And second, it's the birthday of Mr. Jitin Gogoi. 23rd June is the birthday of Nula Rasikan Sangma, the son of Snigdha Sangma. So let us keep all these birthday people in our hearts and prayers during this week.